Bitcoin is not a bubble. Bitcoin actually is the pin. It's the pin that's popping the legacy financial system's bubble, over printing of money, over valuation of stocks and stuff. Bitcoin is a technology. People don't seem to understand. And once they do understand, they come on board. It's a technology. Industrial Revolution changed the world. You know, this is a information calculation, computation, communication, crypto economic revolution that's changing the world right now. And if you don't understand what it is, it takes a little while to learn about it. But once you realize what Bitcoin is, you're going to realize that you're at the ground floor. I mean, was the train a bubble? Some people stayed blacksmiths, like some people are staying goldsmiths, but some people are staying blacksmiths. And, you know, the train's going to pass you by. And then other people became Carnegies and Rockefellers.
The beauty of it, the supporters say, it's decentralized. It's everything that banks aren't, you know.
Nobody buying in today is getting in at the ground floor. I mean, if anything, you're going to be left holding the bag. But Bitcoin is not a technology. The technology is the blockchain. And we can have an argument about, you know, how relevant the blockchain is and how important it may or may not be. But Bitcoin is nothing. It's simply a digital token that utilizes the blockchain. So when you buy into Bitcoin, you don't own anything except that one Bitcoin. You don't have any ownership of any kind of railroad. You've got one car. We have a problem in fiat currencies. But, you know, you mentioned overprinting. We have lots of digital currencies. There's 1,300 of them. There's massive inflation of digital currencies. And even Bitcoin itself has spun off Bitcoin Cash, Bitcoin Gold. There's no limit to the supply of Bitcoin-branded worthless tokens that can be created.
You know, Bitcoin
Cash,
Bitcoin Gold.
Hold on a second. Can I answer this? I mean, what he said was Bitcoin is nothing. He's trying to say that Bitcoin's nothing, but Bitcoin is a reward system, right, for holding up the blockchain. Without Bitcoin's blockchain, Bitcoin's blockchain is the largest blockchain ever. It's the largest, the first one out, and has the most participants. There's millions of mining machines handling all the transactions and all the information and the calculations that are happening on this blockchain. So when you're a miner and you participate in the clearing all this information, you get a piece, a little slice of a Bitcoin as being part of a pool, and the miners get rewarded in Bitcoin for their participation.
It could be the reward, but you don't need Bitcoin to have a blockchain. There are all these other cryptocurrencies that have blockchains and they don't use Bitcoin. And you can use blockchains for anything.
If you don't have a consensus, the largest blockchain is the only one that matters. The largest blockchain is the only one that matters. The one that does the most
work. No, it doesn't.
The most people that are involved is the one that's most trustworthy. Yeah. If you can have a blockchain in your pocket and not have any consensus model or algorithm working, meaning you don't have any miners and you don't have any consensus, it doesn't mean anything. It's just a really, really slow database.
But what?
And that's what it is.
What is the value? What is the inherent value of a Bitcoin? What can you do with a Bitcoin to make it worth $17,000?
Well, you seem to misunderstand, and a lot of people do, and the people who don't misunderstand actually buy it. The reality is Bitcoin is a technology. Satoshis. There's 100 million Satoshis per Bitcoin.
No, it's not a technology. So what can I do with my Bitcoin?
There's 100 million Satoshis. You could buy anything, as a matter of fact. Yeah, I could buy gold at a discount. I go to Paxful.com, and I could buy gold at a discount. I could buy gold at 60% off with Bitcoin.
No, you have
That's
to sell
the Bitcoin.
You have to sell your Bitcoin
buy card. You can
first.
Buy a credit card. No.
People who got in years ago, or even people that got in at the beginning of the year, yes, they have the opportunity to cash out and make a lot of money. But people who are buying into this thing at these prices or higher prices are going to lose basically everything. I mean, these currencies are going to trade to zero or pretty close to it once this bubble pops. There's no value in the Bitcoin. You can't use it as money. It's too slow, it's too expensive, and too volatile. So it's not a medium of exchange. It's not a store of value because there's no value to store. It is a pure speculative digital asset that as soon as it stops going up, it's going to implode.
You can buy anything you buy today. You can buy with Bitcoin. You can buy it at a discount. Yeah, you go to the site and you plug it in and they give you the coupons
for anything
you buy.
No, that's after you sell your Bitcoin. You have to sell the Bitcoin. They don't have any.
No,
they don't have prices in Bitcoin.
You use the Bitcoin to get the coupon.
Hey, you can buy this for...
You've never been on this... Oh, my God.
You use the...
Come on, Peter.
Yes, you're selling your Bitcoin.
What are you talking about?
You're converting it to dollars.
Well, you got to sell your gold to buy something, too. No one's taking your gold. No one's hanging around with a gold test kit taking your gold.
Many thanks to my guest, Peter Schiff, chief exec of Euro Pacific Capital, and Nick Spanos, co-founder of the Zap Project. Thank you, guys.